this flight, we're going to perform a rejected takeoff below 100 knots at London Luton's runway 25. Just taking the aircraft around the turning circle. We've got a takeoff weight today of 65.5 tons, and we've got flex temperature 58 degrees. Config 1, departure. Conditions are dry. So we're going to reject below 100 knots, and usually we'll do this for any ECAM warning or caution. Today we haven't set that up, but usually anything that's going to affect the safety of flight or any cautions that occur. The captain would engage reverse max. The first officer will call reverse green, decel, cancel any alarms or audios, and inform ATC. Announce 70 knots, and then we position the aircraft into nose into the wind to allow any flames to be blown away from the fuselage on an effective engine. And we'll stow reverses, apply the parking brake, and use the emergency evacuation checklist as required, and then cover off any ECAM actions. All happens very quickly, so we'll depart now and run through that. On the tow brakes, throttle's 50%, half side stick down, EGT is looking stable, Amplex 58, SRS runway auto thrust blue. Stop. Reverse green, decel, spoilers, 70 knots. At this point, we consider turning the aircraft into the wind. Not required today, we haven't got any engine fire indications, and we bring the aircraft to a stop. Airline 59 Charlie stopped on the runway. We'd consider the emergency evacuation checklist and any required ECAM actions. One thing to keep an eye on would be brake temperatures. As you can see, they're starting to rise quite a lot. Obviously, depending on the conditions, the weight of the aircraft and so forth, they can get excessively hot, in which case we'd use the brake fan. Temperature of the brakes must be below 300 degrees for a departure. Our next video, we've run through rejected takeoff using toga thrust before V1.